Sometimes I wish I could go back to the good old days. Oh. Back to the days when I was a little younger and more agile.
Hey, have you seen the baby face up?
Yeah, dude.
Dude, imagine at the faculty breakfast.
Mr. Rosa and Coach Pippen, and then like kind
dude,
of
yeah,
Mr. Borey, is everything all right?
Hey, Mr. Borey, we gotta run something by you for the scoreboard.
I'm fine. I was just reminiscing and remembering the good old days. We can go take a look at it.
Come on, Mr. Borey. If we wrestled right now, I'm pretty sure you would take me down. You don't look a day over 40.
Mr. Borey, being young is overrated. According to Twitter, 60% of the people agree that the dad bod's in. Very true.
Are you calling me fat?
Whoa. We're just kidding, Mr. Borey. Well, take us down, please.
Trust me, Christian, it's just an old-timer dream. When you get to my age, you'll wish you looked like this.
We'll see you upstairs.
Maybe one day.
Mr. Boatwright, the right man at the right time, chosen for a job that seemed almost all too perfect for him. And he returned to a campus that he had already been at and began a construction project the likes of which has never been seen before. Of course, with time comes stress and things change, even at this campus where some things never change. Mr. Boatwright has to be careful what he wishes for, though, because little does he know that he has entered the trooper zone.
It is a school as vast as space and as timeless as infinity. It is the middle ground between light and shadow, between science and superstition, and it lies between the pit of man's fears and the summit of his knowledge, better known as McCrae and Debbie Lewis. This is the school of imagination and El Paso's finest. It is an area which we call the Trooper Zone.
We have good
talk about it. Yes. Yes.
Hi, Mr. Boatwright.
Good morning. We've received complaints from multiple parents and students that the environment here on campus is different.
Well, of course it's different. We just built the place.
Lately, Eastwood just isn't the same anymore. That the old school spirit isn't what it used to be. So I ask you all here today to talk about what we can do to make this a better work environment.
I know exactly what you're talking about, Mr. Boatwright. My kids have been saying the same thing. We need more school spirit. Yay!
Not right now, Ashley. I appreciate the enthusiasm, though. What about you, Ms. Galindo? What can you do to help?
I was thinking some team bonding, maybe a spirit day?
With all due respect, Mr. Boatwright, if there's no coffee, there's no spirit.
Listen, guys. In computer science, to solve problems, we talk to the duck. Should we talk to the duck?
See, that's what I'm talking about. Things like that. See, at least someone is taking things seriously.
Mr. Boatwright, I am taking this so seriously.
I tell you what.
I'm gonna go home and get some advice from this from my unborn son. See you guys later.
Look, I literally wear pink pants to school. Do you want me to grow back my mullet, or maybe we should just wrestle again?
Chip, I don't think anyone wants to see that.
It's a look.
What, the pink pants?
No, the mullet.
Well, she's got a point.
Well, you know, the research shows that all you have to do to appear healthier is to smile.
You know what, everyone? Just get out. I will personally be checking up on each of you to see what you're doing is a better environment. You know, sometimes I just wish I was young again. Like the kids, you know.
Well, Coach, just be careful what you wish for.
You know, Chip, you were one of the few that didn't make me upset during the meeting. I really appreciate you paying attention.
Oh, thanks, but I don't really have time for this right now.
I just wanted to stop by and commend you and thank you for doing such a great job and for taking the meeting seriously. Hey, Chip, try and loosen up a little bit. You know, I've been thinking about what you said.
You mean about the duck?
No, about appreciating everything that we've made for ourselves.
Well, Ducky and I, we love to go ahead and provide great words of wisdom. Do you want it, Ducky? Ducky, you and I. Mission accomplished.
Issa, loosen up a little bit, would you?
Okay, sir. So, Ducky, mission accomplished. And what do you think? Another year? Nah.
Dr. Hyder, I hope you're thinking about what we discussed in the meeting.
Well, I haven't really given it much thought yet. I mean, you know, act younger.
Well, I think people can.
Well, what do you got in mind? Grow my hair or de-age myself or something?
Any of those would be great. Paul, would you just loosen up a little bit? Talk to you later.
Hey, you dropped your duck.
Oh, thank you.
Kid, come here. Best thing you can do, wean yourself off of that electronic pacifier of yours.
Hey, what's up, Issa? What you working on?
I'm just doing an assignment for Mr. Gaeta. Apparently I'm a barbarian.
Well, if you think about it, we're all barbarians.
Is everything okay?
Hello, Mrs. Truesdale.
She's not getting you any trouble, is she?
Everything's okay.
Working on Ayala's homework.
Oh, wait, which one? I think I have that class.
Well, there's like four of them.
There's like three Catawbas.
No, Mrs. Majana has a brother.
Chip, I think he's his working. We should leave it.
Truesdale, you need it. Listen up, these students can teach you something.
Hey, Mr. Boatwright. Wanna wrestle?
Hey, you can't talk to the principal like that. Got it.
Whatever, man.
Gosh, I can't believe it.
Sir. Sir, Mr. Boatwright. This school is out of.
I think the school is not out of control.
What? You hung up on me. Not this again.
Hey, Coach Pippen. I feel like I'm getting old. I think you and I need to loosen up a little bit and act a little bit younger.
David, even if I were to act a little bit younger, I'd still be sitting in this same chair.
Something's happened outside. I need to go check it out. I'll talk to you later.
Okay. Some things never change.
Ah, that makes sense now. We're all turning into students.
I wonder what I should do.
That's it. I need to talk to Jake and Ashley. I mean, Mr. Valtierra and Miss O. See what they could do about this. I wonder who they're going to get to replace me.
Hey, David! This is Mr. Boatwright. Dude, you gotta change me back.
Dude, I don't even know how I'm a kid right now. I can't do anything for you.
You know what? Now that I'm bigger than you, it's my turn to
bother
you.
No.
Holy Toledo. Am I hallucinating? What brings you in here? I never see you out here.
Well, Coach, I came to make sure that you're getting your grades into the computer. It's the end of the year.
Computer? What's a computer?
Oh, here we go. Coach, you know, I can always make you a football coach.
Well, you know, you tried that once and it didn't work out too well.
Well, the real reason I came was to tell you that your basketball uniforms have come in and they're the exact colors that you wanted, navy blue and gold.
Oh my goodness, we're back to that same problem again, confusing me with Coronado. Everybody knows that Eastwood's official school colors are royal blue and gold.
Really? Who told you that?
It's in the first yearbook.
Is it? Yes, I'm going to have to go look that
up. You'll have to check that out.
I'll do it. Yep, just the way I left it.